Here we are, back on Throwback Thursday for part 3 of the WWF Superstars. No. Many commentaries. Yeah, part 3. Anyway, I told y'all I was going to let y'all know this bitch is well documented of being a bitch that after leaving WWF, she ain't never did shit with herself. Well, she did come back, I think a year after I ended up meeting her. She ended up coming back and they put her in the Hall of Fame, I think. Or was it the year before? One of those fucking years. She ended up coming to the Hall of Fame and she actually got in shape just for the Hall of Fame. Like, bitch, who you trying to fool? Anyway, I've done met stars that's actual current fucking stars and on TV shows that don't fucking act like, I mean, they just act like people. Don't act like their shit don't stink. This bitch was acting like she was fucking VIP. So when I got up on the stage to take the picture with her, most of them, all of them, will fucking talk to you a while before you take the picture or, you know. She told the security dude, oh, tell him to wait right there for a second. I'm not ready yet. So, you know what I mean? So I had to wait by the steps. For what? Like, you need a pause between fucking each person? You fucking bitch. Like, you ain't shit. Anyway, I seen how she interacted with me, and I seen how she acted to other fucking fans and shit, and it just made me rub me the wrong way. I'm like, oh, you one of them. So anyway, yeah, the bitch got really fucking washed up in her later on life. She's like a complete hag. But on with the show. There's pictures I'm taking right here. And then when she went in the Hall of Fame, they always put together like a video package of each star, like highlights from their career. The video they put together for the Hall of Fame, when they showing her highlights, I'm in it. You can see me in at this day, at this event, like when I'm snapping this particular picture right here. You can see me in the video taking a picture for her Hall of Fame video. If any of y'all see that Hall of Fame video, I'm wearing a white shirt. Yeah, so that was crazy. Years later, I ended up being watching the fucking Hall of Fame coming to go to WrestleMania. I'm like, damn, there's me. I'm also in the WrestleMania 27 DVD, but we'll get to that later. And now we start the show. I'm gonna bring y'all some WWF superstars, so I'm gonna let y'all enjoy this. But just keep your eyes on the young man with the white shirt and the black hat and the book sack. Y'all know what I'm wearing now. That's me in the front row. Not right here. This is a little recap of the Royal Rumble. Fuck y'all, man. I was there. I was ringside when Shawn Michaels retired. The Nation of Domination as well. We're gonna be getting to that story too. Hell yeah, y'all. Put it like this: the people I didn't meet as a teenager and a kid, I ended up meeting when I was an adult. I can't stand Jim Ross. Front cowboy, yeah. Looking forward to someday having the opportunity to compete for the WWF tag title, even though last Monday night on Raw, Furnace and LaFon lost in a very controversial way, I might add. Triple H. Matchup for the team we're about to see right here. The British Bulldog and Slammy Award winning Owen Hart, and the way that Furnace and LaFon lost was that Owen Hart turned in another Slammy Award winning.
winning performance, JR. By the way, would you watch that hat, please? Every time you turn
there we go, y'all just saw some of the pictures I took. Here is the TV show of it. Kind of crazy, huh?
That's the worst line I've ever heard of. Look at the Godwins. Oh, if I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the mud. Well, the Godwins, you know, were...
There you can see me. I'm taking pictures leaning over the thing. They got one shot of me dancing.
I didn't realize that.
I was dancing through the whole thing, though.
So we have now our
four teams. You don't think they're going to turn loose of a pigskin, do you?
And our timekeeper, Sonny, the queen of the Superstars Bowl, rings the bell. We
all right, y'all.
Here in the entire nation of domination.
Y'all finished watching this one, and
may not bode well for the other three teams in this contest. And it's
I'm gonna let y'all get back to this.
By the way, we'll go one on one tomorrow night on Raw.
I'm gonna see y'all next week.
Well, this is gonna be a real.
The World Wrestling Federation. For over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
It was 1 week ago today that the largest wrestling crowd in 5 years flooded the Alamo Dome. Over 60,000 WWF fans gathered to witness San Antonio's native son, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels, compete for the World Wrestling Federation Championship, and Shawn Michaels delivered. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Sunday Morning Superstars here on the USA Network. Hi again, everybody. I'm Jim Ross alongside James E. Cornette. Cornette back from the injured reserve. He's still a little bit of a pain in the neck. But be that as it may, the big news, Shawn Michaels is once again the WWF champion. And in this hour, we will hear from Bret the Hitman Hart, who after this Monday, I'm sure has a lot to say, James E.
But that's not all, because today we have Hunter Hearst Helmsley taking on Ahmed Johnson in a non-title contest. And you talk about the Super Bowl today? Well, we've got the Superstar Bowl. And what would a bowl be, JR, without a queen? Here is the queen of the Superstar Bowl, Sonny.
Complete passes thrown her way.
Oh, JR, I'm so sick of hearing. You know, it's a well-documented fact I hate football, but I've been looking forward to today because instead of the Super Bowl, we've got the Superstars Bowl, and it's going to be a tremendous matchup. And after all, Sonny is the bell of the bowl.
Well, why don't you tell us the rules of this very unique contest we're about to see here this morning on Sunday Morning Superstars.
Well, it's really quite simple, JR. Four teams are involved, a team in each corner of the ring. A tag can be made to any man, not just your partner. Failure to accept the tag is an automatic disqualification. When a man is pinned, his team is eliminated, and the last team remaining is the winner. If I was Hillbilly Jim calling strategy for the Godwins, I would say the best strategy to the other teams, get them in. Tag the other guys, leave your partner and yourself on the apron to rest until the field gets cleared.
Nation of Domination, certainly very prevalent yesterday afternoon in Madison Square Garden. We'll show you some exclusive footage from MSG a little bit later here this morning. It seems as if the Nation of Domination has a new member. We'll have more on that. Of course, also some exclusive footage from last night's Shotgun Saturday Night involving the Nation of Domination as well. But this is the first time to date that we have seen Farouk and Crush one-on-one in a tag team matchup here.
Boy, I tell you what, the Nation of Domination is multiplying as time goes on. There's more and more of them every day.
And here comes Doug Furness and Philip LaFon. Outstanding tag team combination. For over 5 years, regular tag team partners with the All Japan Wrestling Organization based in Tokyo. Former All-Asian Tag Team Champions. Certainly looking forward to someday having the opportunity to compete for the WWF Tag Title, even though last Monday night on Raw, Furnas and LaFond lost in a very controversial way, I might add, a non-title matchup with a team we're about to see right here.
The British Bulldog and Slammy Award-winning Owen Hart, and the way that Furnas and LaFond lost was that Owen Hart turned in another Slammy Award-winning performance, JR. By the way, would you watch that hat, please? Every time you turn your head, you like to knock me out.
Well, I like my new hat. Matter of fact, my new line of hats will be out by Christmas, I hope.
That's the worst line I've ever heard of. Look at the Godwins. Oh, if I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the... Well, the Godwins, you know, were both MVPs in the 1986 Arkansas Toilet Bowl. Oh, did you realize that?
I didn't realize that.
Yes.
So we have now our four
teams.
You
don't think they're going to turn loose of a pigskin, do you?
And our timekeeper, Sonny, the queen of the Superstars Bowl, rings the bell. We are ready to go here, and the entire Nation of Domination remaining out here. That may not bode well for the other three teams in this contest. And it's Philip LaFond and the British Bulldog, who, by the way, will go one-on-one tomorrow night on Raw right here on the USA Network.
Well, this is going to be a real interesting match.
Talking to who?
What? We got... That's Rocky Maivia. What's he doing talking to... And Brady's even laughing.
That's back in the locker room area. The honky-tonk man having a conversation with Rocky Maivia. What could that be about? We'll try to keep you updated on that. Folks, the Superstar Bowl continues. Don't go away. Just when I met Justin Field yesterday in Madison Square Garden, and the Nation of Domination have won the first Superstars Bowl right here on Super Sunday. As this huge crowd looks on, the Nation of Domination is getting stronger and stronger by the day.
Well, Furnas tried to save it, but Crush had him by the leg. The Dominators fell defeat for Furnas and LaFond. Ah, give me the Superstar Bowl any day. No timeouts, no halftime, no huddling. It's all action. And the Nation of Domination come out on top of the first annual Superstar Bowl. What a match. What a day.
Woo. Folks, Western...
Here we come when we rolling up, jumping out the truck, now they know we blowing up. And hold up, showing up, we gonna shatter the glass, set the windows up. 18's in the back, hit a bass thump. It's King Kong, I don't think they really want none. Let it pump, vibrate the house. Rear view mirror shaking like a train's in time. This how we doing it every day, doing shows on the road from state to state. Selling CDs like we slanging some crack in. The studio is like the kitchen where I cook it in. And the corner be the record store. The way they loving it, they coming knocking at my door. Drop another CD for that ass. Come put $10 in my hand and it's yours. Come take it and open it. Put it in your CD player like you were smoking it. From the dirty south to California, coast to coast, we banging hits out for
oh,
ya.
No, look here they go. Cause we roll, bouncing coast to coast. Oh no, look here they go. Cause we roll, bouncing coast to coast.
Coast to coast, here we come.
Rapidly gaining in popularity here at the World Wrestling Federation. And by the way, still to come this morning, an exciting tag match from the AAA Wrestling Organization. We'll also show you some highlights from Shotgun Saturday Night, which was last night. And we'll show you how Hunter Hearst Helmsley was tombstone piled driven by The Undertaker on an escalator.
He took a ride that I think that nobody who's ever ridden an escalator in Penn Station has taken before. But, well, that is a wonderful prop that Marlena is wearing this morning, isn't it, JR?
Well, that outfit doesn't leave much to the imagination.
That's okay. My imagination isn't that vivid. I need it laid right out in front of me.
Well, Marlena has already proven that she will do whatever it takes to helped Goldust. As a matter of fact, do you remember, to take you back, the Shotgun Saturday night several weeks ago, it was Goldust and the Sultan one-on-one, and of course, Marlena. Whoa!